Well, hello friends, welcome to Rewake Videos. My name is William. So excited that you are with us today. So a lot of people always ask me questions like which ETF should I buy, which stock should I buy, which company should I invest in, which ETN, which basket, which portfolio, bundles and all that, because they want to invest in something they know will be lucrative for them and would be safe. And I always tell them that, you know, if you go big, then you'll be safe. When I say that, I'm referring to you know, the company's market cap. I'm talking about the return of the company. I'm talking about the history. So if you want to be safe and invest in a company that you know will give you returns, you have to look at big companies, right? That's why a lot of times when you go to companies like F&B, Allen Gray, and so forth, your Coshes, your Satrix, when you invest with them, and they invest in their ETFs, or when you look at their ETFs and what they invest in, you would see a lot of times you would find top 40 companies. You would find companies that are big and companies that have been there, right? Because they're trying to be safe so that you can be able to make a return, you know, on your investment. So today I want to look at a company called Clicks. I want to show you just a brief information of Clicks. Clicks is one of the biggest companies in South Africa. It's one of the biggest companies in South Africa, and it's in the top 40. So what that means is that you'd be able to make money if you were to invest in Clicks, right? So now we're going to be looking at Clicks, just the minor information, nothing big, but just minor information. Their financials, their chart, who they are, you know, just so that you can be able to see that it is worth investing in. And maybe for the next couple of days we'll be looking at top 40 companies, but we are starting with Clicks so that you can be able to see that, given the information that I'm going to show you, it is worth your investment, right? So let's go and check it out. We're going to click on shares and we're going to click on Clicks. There we go. Clicks Group LTD, Clicks Group Limited. So we're going to try and check out the information so that you can be able to see. So I'm going to be reading quickly and just going through it quickly so that you can be able to see the information. You can research for yourself, go and download SA Shares, MoneyWeb as well, and they will give you this information so that you can be able to know, you know, the company that you want to invest in. For instance, now Clicks, as I said on the previous video, that SA Shares is 15 minutes delayed, you know, but today when they closed, Clicks closed at 24688, -597, -2.36%, right? So it falls under shares down, the tab. If you open SA Shares, you'll see there's a tab written shares down, meaning there are companies that went a bit down, or down, right? Today, this is the information for today, right? Not for the year or 10 years or no, for today, right? So the company can go down today, but tomorrow go as high as 15%. Right, so grand. So when you look at the market data, it previously closed, which is yesterday, 24688, right? But when it opened on 25,000, right? So the best bid and best offer, they're not written, but the volume is 568,952. Days range is between 24,594 to 25,282. Remember, this can vary depending on how the company is performing on the day, right? If you look just on top, you'll see the 10-day trading range, you see. So that determines the day's range, right? Great. So the PE ratio is 23.78. The EPS to TTM is 10.38.00. DPS 6.42. Dividend yield is 2.60. The market cap is 60.23, right? So their shares in issue is 243.97. We're talking just minor information when we're looking at this, you know, so that you can be able to see that they are making money. And it is a ever-growing company, right? So we're talking billions, we're talking millions, right? So that you'd be able to understand what I'm saying, that this is a company that is worth investing in, right? Remember that this information can change, you know, but the market cap takes a bit, you know, couple of months to year or years for it to change, and you know, depending on how the company is performing. But either way, this information varies, you know. So let's go to the chart and we want to see how it has been performing for the past year. As you can see, for the past day, it went down from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. and 5 p.m. The you know, it started on 25,000, as they said, and it stopped on, you know, 24,000 and a couple, you know. So as you can see that it went down on a day. Let's see 2 days. When you look at 2 days, there's been a downward spiral, right? Let's look at 3 months. When you look at 3 months, that there's that downward spiral, but there's that equilibrium state, you know. So between 25,000 couple and 26,000 couple, there is that equilibrium state, right? But now it went a bit deeper, right? So let's look at a year. When you look at a year, you see that downward spiral. We don't know what sparks that. Maybe it's how the economy is currently and the GDP. But basically, you can see that there's that downward spiral, but there is that equilibrium state between 25,000 and 30,000 clicks, right? So when we look at 3 years, we see now a change. So for short-term investors, when you look at a year, you see that there's a downward spiral. When you look at 2 days, there's a downward spiral, right? But for people who are long-term investors, they would look at 3 years, they would see that, oh, there's a upward spiral, meaning that it shows potential for growth. But between 30 and 30,000 clicks and 25,000 clicks, there is something that happened that is affecting the company that makes it go down, right? So is it worth investing? For me, it's still worth investing. Why? Let's look at 5 years. Look at that growth in 5 years, just in 5 years. So if you're into invest money for 5 years in clicks, maybe you would have a better return, you know. So let's look at 10 years. The past 10 years, you can see that between 2019 and 2021, there is that downward spiral, which is caused by what you call this COVID. But in 2020, it was going up, and COVID happened, and everything was shut down, and it went down. But it kicked back again in 2021, going to 2023. So there is that upward spiral that says that this company wants to be able to grow. So it is worth your investment because the CEOs and the employees are doing whatever they can so that this company can be able to grow, which means as a as an investor or potential investor, you'd be able to make money and you'd be able to see a profit. But remember that things can change anytime. You'd find that this company is going down forever, you know, or maybe this company is trying to find a you know, it's going to find a stability between 25 to 30,000 clicks, or between 20 to 30,000 clicks, right? So that's the information worth looking at as well. But Clicks is an old company, right? It has been here. For instance, let's look at here. Clicks Group Ltd. Listed on the JSE main board, JSE sector. It's a consumer staples, personal care, drugs, and grocery stores. These are drug retailers. So short name Clicks, code CLS. It has a registration number there, an ISIN number. It was founded, as I was saying, it is an old company. It was founded on the 1st of January 1968, and was listed on the 20 of March 1996, right? Employees are 15,000 to 16,000, controlled by Sessional or management voting pool. So shares in value 243.97 M, and issue volatility is 5.86. Liquidity beta 76.90, and beta negative 0.15, right? Clicks is a retail-led health group which is listed in the personal care, drug and grocery store sector on the JSE, founded in the 1968. Clicks is the country's leading health, beauty and wellness retailer and the largest retail pharmacy chain, with an expanding network of 840 stores and 673 pharmacies, supported by a growing digital presence, right? UPD is the country's leading full range pharmaceutical wholesaler, providing the distribution capacity for the group's healthcare strategy. So let's go a bit down. There's information that I wanted to share with you, but now I can't see it. But basically, it's an old company, it's a reliable company, it has been there. And it's ever growing, right? So for me, if you were looking for a safe place to invest, maybe for 10, 20 years and get paid dividends, this is one of the safest places that you would invest in, right? This is one of the safest places that you invest in. So it's on the top 40, it's ever growing. Should there be problems, you know, maybe you would take your investment somewhere else, right? But as you can see on the second paragraph, they're saying that listed on the JSE since 1996, Clicks Group sustained financial performance and growth in shareholder value has been see has seen the group included in the FTSE JSE Top 40 Index for the past 5 years. So it has been on the Top 40 Index for the past 5 years, right? So this is a growing company that we're talking about. So let's look at their calendar. Let's look at the calendar. You know, the calendar, they give you their financial year and when they pay off dividends, right? So they paid off an interim dividend before the board met. So they paid off a second interim dividend, firstly on 2023-06, then again on 20. Okay, so they are yet to do that. They're yet to do that. 2023, June, I think, January, February, March, April, May, June, yeah, and July as well, before the board meets. But I think, yeah, we'll see. This is their future calendar. So these are the way it's ticked. It means that it has happened. So we'll see if they will pay off their dividends and so forth. So if they're a dividend paying company, that means that maybe you get paid, like they say here, their investors are going to get paid twice. So which is 2023-06-27 and 07-03, right? So they're going to get paid twice. So if you have invested a lot of money, then you would get a lot in your return, right? So yeah, that's that. When you look at that calendar, especially when you are an investor already. So another thing that I wanted to look at is news. So news, they show you everything that is happening with clicks. So should they change a CEO? Should they be, so the board meet and discuss something, or something happened, people are getting unemployed, you know, retrenched, I mean to say, and so forth. So the information will appear here, you know, so that you can be able to know the company and keep in touch with the company. So for instance, let's look at the one on top. So Clicks Group Limited, unaudited interim results for the 6 months ended 28 February 2023, and cash dividend declaration. Revenue for the interim period to 21.353 billion, and gross profit rose 8.2 to 4.4 billion. Operating profit went down 1.4, which is 1.6 billion. Profit for the period went down 1.1 billion. Furthermore, headline earning per share for continuing operations grew 1.1, which is 4.722 per share. So if you continue on reading, you see they talk a lot about money. Look at the last paragraph. Record capital investment of 958 million is planned for a full financial year. This includes 477 million for rents for new stores and pharmacies, and the refurbishment of 45 stores. All right, so as you can see, they have a vision for this year, and it's going to cost them an X amount of money. New stores, 477 million. Refurbishing old stores, and okay, the 477 million also includes the refurbishing of old stores. 481 million will be invested in supply chain technology and infrastructure, including batteries, storage at UPD's main distribution centers. So as you can see, they give you the information that you need, and they tell you how much they're going to spend and what is intended, you know. And as an investor, you feel you are part of the company, because it tells you how much they're making, how much they're going to spend, how much you're going to get paid, and so forth. So it is, for me, it is worth investing. So if you have a 100 Rand, 1,000 Rand, 10,000 Rand, 100,000 Rand, 1 million, I would suggest that you buy shares and, you know, hope for the best, you know. So when you go to the financials, they give you everything. They give you the turnover, the operating profit margin. They give you the market cap, the fixed assets. They give you the net asset value per share. They give you the return on total assets, return on shareholder funds. So this information will be able to help you to see how much the company is making, and this is the 6 months interim, right? It was published on April 2023. So this will help you in terms of knowing the financials of the company. If you are not satisfied with this, then you would be able to go for, other research, like you go to MoneyWeb, you go to JSE, you go to different, platforms, so that you can be able to get the information that you need, especially Yahoo. They will give you also in a detailed form to explain to you in the financials in a detailed form. So I see this is a rough estimation, not really a rough estimation, but they just write numbers, and it might be confusing for people who don't understand. But basically, they give you the information, and I promise you this. This company is a great company to invest in. If you're not sure about it, you can invest in indexes such as Cetrix Top 40 or Allen Gray Top 40, whereby they invest in all the Top 40 companies if you don't want to invest in one particular company. But my advice would be investing in all those top 40 companies separate from their ETF or index, right? So when you invest in their stocks, in their companies separate, and you come back and you go to the top 40 and invest in the top 40 ETFs, so you are giving yourself you are sort of like diversifying your portfolio, right? So should any company be kicked out of the top 40 margin, there's another company that will be placed in, so your money would be safe, right? So secondly, in a way, you are diversifying your portfolio in a way, right? So you are playing it safe so that you can be able to make a profit. Secondly, there are different kinds of ETFs that have top 40 companies. So there is Allen Gray, for instance, and there's CoShares, and there is Cetrix, right? So I think F&B also have is it top 100 or top 40? Those will help you in diversifying your portfolio and making sure, because every ETF will pay you differently, their fees are different, that's what I wanted to say, their fees are different. So when you invest in different ETFs, maybe Cetrix, maybe Allen Gray, they will pay you, like their fees are different, so fine. But when you go straight to the company as well, you are playing it safe. The company might pay you R100, and the ETF might pay you 98 rand. For you are making money because you are playing it safe. So I would suggest that you do something like that. And also, remember that in the top 40 in itself, when you invest in them, you are diversifying your portfolio, because there is mining, there is retail, there is property in those top 40 companies, right? So when you invest in them, you are able to diversify your portfolio. Guys, that is me. Please hit that subscribe button. Please hit that notification button. Make your own research and let's talk together and grow together. Please comment down below. Tell me what you think. Hit that like button. Hit the notification button. Hit that subscribe button. And, if people have questions about investing, share these videos so that they can be able to be answered. Thank you so much. Enjoy your day. Please note, views and opinions in this audio or video should not be taken as financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor, nor am I registered with FSCA.